Hi, my name's Flare Knight, and sometimes I hide my taskbar and then lose it.
Hi, I'm Agent, and,
I can't be trusted with secrets.
I can't be trusted with secrets.
And, yeah, so we're good. The Roger woke up, so he's gonna be on the pitch again.
Yes.
Forever.
Forever.
This is the most amazing thing ever.
Like... What the hell? They stunned every member of his team except three.
That four. That was certainly a pitch invasion. Three of my dudes went down, but a lot more of his went down. And basically what that means is I score now. Yay.
Yay, I win.
Actually, that's fairly accurate. Because him stopping me is going to take something special, honestly. I'm either going to have to roll snakes... or something else bad is going to have to happen, because the chance of me not scoring is slim. I'm also going to blitz this Chaos Warrior with my Mighty Blow guy, because... Well, Mighty
he
Blow.
Still hasn't killed anyone this entire game.
Yeah, nobody. He's killed nobody. He's the friendliest.
Yeah.
And he still isn't going to kill anybody.
Yeah, I'm thinking he might be a pacifist. Maybe he needs to go train with the gutter runners.
Maybe.
And be a runner.
So, my thrower went down, and because my thrower went down, I can't really do a normal Skaven drive. Obviously, right. I don't have to, because, all of his team fell down. But I can't do a normal one. So, instead of a normal one, also, by the way, Pangalactic Gargle Blaster leveled up on that last touchdown.
And Johnny is 7 SPP from a level.
Is it 7? Yeah, 7.
Before
and
1.
Yeah, definitely 7. And so, instead of doing a normal one, I decide I'm just gonna give the ball to Johnny and say, Johnny, go. Fly, you fool.
And Johnny's like, well, okay, if you say so.
Sure, why not? I can run. And so he just runs over here. And I start counting squares, and I'm like, okay, well, that guy can blitz me probably no matter what. That guy can blitz me with a going for it, and now he can't. So, only number 8 can blitz me.
Wait, what? Okay, that was a weird skip in the video.
I had to cut out a bunch of time, because I spent a lot of time counting squares and thinking about what to do.
Okay. Because I was seeing number 5 in one corner of the screen, and suddenly he's marking number 3 there.
Yeah, I must have messed up the editing a little bit, but whatever. And then the Minotaur decides he doesn't want to live anymore, and he'd rather take a nap.
Yelp. Okay, that was really weird.
He felt the going for it on the blitz, and then just fell down. And so...
He was standing in the square, and then he was like, oh, wait, no. Tonk. It's like he stepped in some type of
poop.
Bag.
He's a cow. He stepped in poop. And so, again, failing to kill anybody ever.
And that's the minus armor value guy, too. He needs to prove his worth or something.
And then I decide just to score. Go screw around with it. If I was a horrible person, I would then stall forever, because there's nothing he could do about it. But I'm not a horrible person, so I scored.
At least one more time.
Yeah. And also, now that I'm up 3-0, I've basically won the game. I mean, there's nothing he can do now, except kill dudes.
Not that that's going to happen.
Not that that's going to happen, though.
No. We're good. Why don't you make a short kick here?
Hoping for a blitz.
Okay.
If he sets up strong to one side like he did, most of his strength is off to that left, kick short into the other side and hope for a blitz. And if it is a blitz, then you pick it up and you run away and you win. If it isn't a blitz... Hopefully it is difficult enough for him to move the ball back to the side he wants it on that he screws something up or leaves it vulnerable.
I see.
See, for instance, now he has to pick it up because where it is not safe at all, even a little bit. So he has to either rotate his dudes back to the other side to make it safe over there.
Right.
Or he has to pick it up and do something with it. So he's given a choice between kind of delaying himself a turn, moving over to the right...
Right.
Or rolling dice and possibly turning over. And if he turns, over, of course,
get the ball,
run away. I won't murder any. I won't murder anything because that's impossible.
That random, you're rats, man. Murders.
So obviously you can tell what he's trying to do. He's going to go cage up the Minotaur like he wanted to.
Right.
And he's just going to roll. He's going to choose the roll the dice option.
And Edom the Torpedos is down again.
I'm really hoping Feather takes a perm.
I'm hoping for the I want the loner to die, and I want Feta to take minus strength. Is there a maximum of subtractive points you can have total? I know you can only get down to like one strength and one agility, but is there like a point where it goes you can't have any more permanent injuries?
No. I mean, it's very unlikely you're going to get a bunch, because the chance of having a permanent injury is the same odds of dying.
Right.
So basically, he's narrowly avoided death twice, which doesn't happen all the time. I know you cannot get more than +2 of any given stat. For instance, even if I rolled more strength on my Minotaur and Fumble, he could not have 8 strength. It doesn't
work.
I don't know. Look at that.
Does he catch with the third hand? Let's see. Nope.
You know the best thing? You know the best thing now?
What?
He has the blitz and he just doesn't use it. He doesn't even blitz. He just doesn't.
What were we talking about?
I don't know if you can have more than -2 of the one stat. Like, if you had a player with 4 strength, could he lose strength 3 times and become 1 strength? I don't know. I do know that if the line rat lost strength, we'd still keep him because it would be funny, but he would be useless. He would be very, very bad. If he lost armor or movement or anything other than strength, he would still be, you know, acceptable. But if he lost strength, he would actually be a useless player. Not that I would fire him, because it's funny, but he would.
Well, I mean, he's technically not useless so long as he can...
knock somebody down.
Something happening?
He knocked someone down. Something might happen.
Something's happening? Nah.
Why would you think that, you silly person?
I don't know. I
don't want the road,
you know, me
over there, but he doesn't.
You know, you look in the dictionary and there's a picture of me next to the word gullible.
And so I wanted the Roger to go stand next to the Minotaur just to cause problems, but he wouldn't. So I said, well, here, have a line rat. As long as the line rat's standing there, see, he has a choice. He can blitz the line rat off.
Right.
Or
which makes him frenzy and then pushes.
Well, no, I'm talking about blitzing off with someone else.
Oh.
And then try to move the Minotaur without a blitz. Or he can blitz with the Minotaur, but he can't move after because he'd be standing next to the Storm Vermin.
Right.
Or he can just punch with the Minotaur and then try to cage up around him. So I just gave him a couple bad options, is basically what they tried to do.
He sat there for a little while and he considered them.
He did. He considered them for a long while.
Then somebody...
And then, oh!
Nope. Nothing.
Just badly hurt. Oh, so close. I won.
He'll even be back next game.
He tried so hard.
He'll even be back next game. He's fine.
The loner, on the other hand, is holding up remarkably well.
I don't know why, but the way you said that was hilarious.
He's everything I wanted out of a lineman. He exists and isn't dead. notice I put number 9. That's the plus agility dude way in the back because I didn't want him to get punched.
Right.
I didn't want to use him as part of the screen because, no Apo. He might get dead. So.
Right. Then that would just be bad.
That would be bad. Very, very bad.
Bad. Very bad. Not a good thing.
And so now he can just move the if the Minotaur will, he can just walk one space back and the Minotaur will be all caged up and fine. But the Minotaur doesn't want to move.
He likes his spot there. So he can just cage around where the Minotaur wants to stay.
Yeah, he can. And he's got enough dudes to run people down. And at least kind of cage up. I can still throw a -2 DB at him. Or with a line rat. Bad news, we lost Flare Knight. His video didn't download correctly, and because right now is Sunday night and I have to be up early tomorrow, I cannot wait for him to fix it. So I am flying solo. He has taught me many lessons. I have come to know myself better as a person, and I am now solo commentating. I stand up the loner. I was originally not going to stand him up because I thought to myself, well, why get a Ryan rat punched? Then I realized it was a loner, and I thought to myself, well, that's why. Oh, no, no one can laugh at my jokes now. This is terrible. Yeah! He KO'd somebody, finally. He did a thing. It didn't give him any SPP, but it was a thing. Also, I noticed that number 5 was surfable, and I figured that that was more important. Surfing people's actually really good, just because it guarantees them off the pitch. You'd think that, oh, well, I shouldn't commit too much, but you'd be wrong. Hey, especially with a fast team like Skaven, I can push this guy out, and he cannot actually get away. If I was slow, like say I was Orcs, and both of those gunners, oh, ooh. Can't do it. Yes. And both of those gunners only had 4 movement. If I moved them all the way to this sideline, and he ran all the way to the other side of the pitch, I would have trouble catching him. And so putting those guys way over there would be bad. But because they're so fast, I can get to him wherever he goes. And the Roger actually managed to punch someone, which was cool. And I paid for the surf. So he's not in a bad situation. I mean, it's not bad. He can free up and he can run down the pitch and try to score, and hopefully I'll be able to stop him. I'm going to have a hard time punching him. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, what happened? Uh-oh, but thrower got missed next game. That's trouble. We're down a dude. Again. So I'm going to have a really difficult time punching him. Right now, I don't have enough rats. Just looking here, what do I got? 7 rats on the pitch. That's not really enough to throw a punch with a gunner. It's might be enough to throw a punch with a three strength dude. But I don't have any of those standing or in a position to throw that punch. Number 13 is a loner, so I don't want to dodge with him. Number 2 and number 5 could do it if he doesn't move that Chaos Warrior to stop him, which he just did. So that's not going to happen. So the only way I can stop him is I have 2 options. I can Roger punch. I can blitz with the Roger and make a break tackle attempt. Or I can just stick a gunner on the Minotaur and just hope that the Minotaur doesn't knock him down, which is kind of dangerous, actually. So I spend a decent while thinking about it. I've been thinking about it. I tend to think about my teams about halfway through the other person's turn. So it doesn't look like I spend a lot of time thinking when I start a turn for the most part. That's because I've been thinking since they started the turn. Which is awful, because sometimes I'll come up with plans, and then he'll foil the plan, and I'll get really mad in my head. Well, I shouldn't say mad, but I'll get upset in my head and be like, oh god, he just screwed up the thing I was going to do that he didn't know about. So, I'm thinking, and that's good, and I wasn't going to stand, again, I don't want to stand, if number 13 was a normal line wrap, I wouldn't stand him up, because there's not much reason to be next to that guy. But he's a loner, so I don't care. Always stand up loners. Never not stand up loners. Also, we'll run Johnny down the pitch just in case the ball comes out. He can be in a position to grab it and run the way away next turn. Always have a plan for that. I'll throw a 1DB because I like him. Also, it frees up my kick line rat, so we can run over here. Not really doing anything particularly useful over there, but what the hell. And now make the rubber ball punch. Fuck my Roger. That's all I have to say. I hope he dies on this block right here. I'm going to have to re-roll that wild animal, because I just can't not re-roll it, and I hope he double skulls and dies. That'd be poetic and perfect, and I hope it happens. And oh, no, he just fell down on me. Huh. That's not right. Number 11 is the Blodge Sidestepper. So now he's got a sidestep dude on him. I'm hoping that if he blitzes with the Mino, he just won't roll path. And then he can't go anywhere, and I'll get another chance to punch him. I also sidestep further away from the end zone, because even if he does roll to pal like this, he has to follow up, and it makes him further away. Notice now that he would need two going forwards to score. So, very, very sneaky sidestepping. He thought about making the going forwards right now. Maybe it would be more likely than anything else, but he's got a bunch of dudes, so he can probably make it pretty safe so he doesn't. If he cages up, I'm going to have a heck of a time punching him. Right now, the Rover is going to doesn't need a DFI, but he's going to probably need to make a break tackle attempt to get in, and that's before he moves the rest of his dudes. So, that's trouble. And now, the Rover can't really make that break tackle attempt, because he'd need to make two dodges, which ain't gonna happen. He does, however, leave Johnny free, so just in case it happens, maybe Johnny can just run away. That'd be great. Never know, ball could come out. Ball can always come out. Escaping. If I had strip ball, this would be a lot easier, because I would just throw the negative 2 dB, and most of the time the ball would come out, and it would be really funny. PMJ's team would actually be completely countered by a good set of strip ball right now, but I'm thinking about how to stop this touchdown, and I decided the only way I'm going to do it, the only way I even have a chance, is if I mark the Minotaur with my blodging sidestepper again. I don't have any way to punch him, and if I mark him with anybody else, he can just get punched off really easily. In fact, the Minotaur could actually, if I marked him with anyone who wasn't a blodging sidestepper, he could actually just punch him right into the end zone and score. With Frenzy, you can just punch and follow up. He'd get surfed, and he would score, and it would be terrible, so I need to use the sidestepper. So that's why I had to do that block. And the Rover behaves. Now he stands up, so he can totally get punched again. You know, me and the Rover, we've come to an understanding. He never actually takes his turn. He never actually does his turn correctly, and I don't expect him to. It works for us. It's an odd relationship, but it works. There are actually turns where you need the Rover to work, and that's always disappointing when it doesn't. Most of the time, he really just serves as a good cage marker or breaker. He just hasn't been doing his job in the past couple of games. Would have really helped last game. He took a lot of naps last game. This game hasn't been as bad as I make it seem. So again, PMJ is faced with the option. He can try to use another player to blitz off the sidestepper, but it doesn't make much sense. In the end, he's just going to have to blitz with the Mino and hope for a pow. It takes him an awfully long time to figure that out. Oh, that's right. He thought, that's right, I forgot. He could technically blitz with somebody else and block all of the places my sidestepper could sidestep to, allowing his Mino to just run in. But he, wild animals, it didn't even happen. He decides this is a better option. All he's got to do is roll a pow. He gets 6 block dice. I'm hoping for the best. And the best didn't happen. So that's a touchdown. I just hope my guy doesn't die. Nope, he's fine. And I don't want to pump it up too much, but this next drive is possibly my favorite drive ever of this game. Or possibly this game and the previous games where I lost. Yeah, good camera work, Cyanide. I'm three rats down, four rats down. He's four dudes down. I'm pretty happy with that. He doesn't have enough dudes to put up anything resembling a defense. I also don't have enough dudes to put up anything to put up an offense I want. I start to make a normal Skaven offense. This is me attempting to make a normal Skaven offense before realizing I only have seven rats, and I'm up 3-1, and he doesn't have a very good setup, and I actually think my odds are more likely if I just try to one turn. So I change my mind, and instead of going for the two-turn attempt, I said, screw it, I'm just going to one-turn with Johnny, and this is how we're going to do it. I want to push number 10 diagonally into number 13, who will then be pushed into Johnny, who will then be one space closer, which is enough to score. The Roger is going to do the blitz, because he's the only one who can get a 2DB on number 10. So I have no choice but to trust him. And then this happens. A riot in turn 15, which leaves me with one turn. If I hadn't already been planning to one turn, I would have been unable to score. I laughed so hard. It was hilarious. And then the Roger does this. You will not believe it. He punches somebody. He actually hurts them. Or he actually pows them. I could take the push here and try to make even less going for it. I decided I want to. I decide I'm okay with doing the going for it. I'd rather just knock the dude down and get SPP on the Mino. The Roger. It's not a Mino. It's a Roger. And now for the handoff. Nope. Well, that was anticlimactic. I thought it was really, really great when I set up for a one turn, and then a riot happened, so I actually only had one turn, and everything was going to be amazing, and the crowd was going to go wild, and then I snaked a pickup. So, whatever. I still win 3-1. Now he gets his free punches. He's probably going to be punching Johnny. Let's hope nothing bad happens. We're already down 2 missed next games for next time. Well, I guess one Snake Eyes deserves another. And stunned, and that's game. I love that last turn. I love it. It's so funny to me. Both two sets of Snake Eyes, a riot. It was hilarious. I love it. I decided to reroll my winnings because I'd like to get more, and I rolled a 6. So I have a ton of money now. Everyone loves money. He got Chaos Warrior MVP, which is great for him. Chaos Warriors love MVPs. And Lenny got an MVP, which is also great for him, because now he's only 2 SVP from a level. Of course, he'll never actually Kaz anybody to get that level, but that's okay. We love you anyway, Lenny. I don't know why I looked at the screen for so long. I was seriously thinking bye. I was actually very confused about what was going on. Came to my senses. We have 2 level ups to actually vote. We actually get a vote this time. Now, Speedy, he's our plus agility leaper. And Pangolette Gurgle Blaster, he's the blodging sidestepper. Speedy, he rolls normals. Things like block or wrestle would be great because he needs to be protected. His next level up is going to come at 51 SPP. That's 20 SPP from now, so it's a little ways away. Same thing for Speedy. He also rolls normals, but he's already got blocks, so he has a ton of things he can pick. I have no opinion. If you find something. What Dauntless? Dauntless would be cool. Or Dirty Player. No, Dirty Player is bad. Frenzy? Yeah, that's bad too. What am I thinking? Sure Hands. Yeah, Sure Hands is perfect. So, that's it. That's the game. We actually won this week. I was very happy with it. Me and PMJ had a good time playing. I hope you had a good time watching. Flare Knight will be back next time when we fix this audio thing. See ya.